He'll watch a movie, then he'll tell you all about it. It's the Armstrong Entertainment Show.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Armstrong Entertainment. This is Chad here, and I saw the Netflix streaming documentary, Taylor Swift, Miss Americana. I wasn't going to do a review for this because I thought, what's the point? But then I realized I haven't done a review in a while, and no movies are coming out in January, so here you have it. So this documentary takes place over the past two-ish years of Taylor Swift's life. Behind the scenes, she explains a lot, and she gets into her life. Now, Taylor Swift is one of those celebrities that people love to hate, like Anne Hathaway or Kim Kardashian. But love her or hate her, you have to give her credit. She is one incredible songwriter. She's probably one of the best songwriters of all time. I compare Taylor Swift a lot to Dolly Parton. They're both from Nashville. They're both singer-songwriters. They're both blonde-haired, beautiful. They both have boobs. They both don't talk about their politics. They're both country artists. They have a lot of similarities, and I feel that Taylor Swift is kind of not as loved as Dolly Parton, but she's definitely in that same realm, and she has a lot of similar qualities. But I would say, in this documentary, I feel like Taylor Swift does something that Dolly Parton has never done, and that is talk about politics. The documentary does go into some raw and honest moments that I really enjoyed. That was definitely my favorite part of this documentary, is when she got real and she felt real. Some of this, she's one of those people who just feels so calculated, and it almost seemed like part of this documentary was to show that she wasn't this one type of way. Do you understand what I'm saying? I think this is the problem with Taylor Swift that a lot of people have, is they think that she's phony and fake and she's calculated and doing things that she's probably just being this honest, good girl that she self-proclaims herself to be. And I'm leaning towards, I believe her. I think she is this good girl. And I think she has a little bit of an arrested development. She does not seem 30 to me. She seems more like she's stuck in 22 years old. Kind of like me. I'm a child at heart. And I'm pretty dumb. And Taylor Swift falls in the same category as myself, I would say. But the fact that she actually reached out on Twitter and showed her viewpoints politically, I thought was a great moment for her. And I'm so glad she did it, because she has such a platform and such a voice that she is really able to turn the tides, and her voice matters and it does count. And I see the flip side where who cares what Taylor Swift thinks, but by not saying anything, she's like Dolly Parton, where it's like, Dolly, I wish you would just say something. Just say you don't like Trump. Say something. Her not saying something speaks volumes. Wow, I just went into a tangent about Dolly Parton, but I hope you understand what I'm saying. Let's get back to this documentary. Her songwriting process was so interesting. Again, you think, is this for real? Is this really how she came up with these songs? And she's just like humming and singing, and then all of a sudden she like nails a lyric, and you're like, holy shit, that's incredible. If this is all true, I'm sure some of it's a little fabricated and edited, but it was pretty amazing. Like, you just are like, how did she do this? Like, it's incredible and so catchy, and I loved watching the process of her writing these songs, and her vision was very interesting. It just shows you, again, how talented she is. So overall, if you like Taylor Swift, you're gonna like this documentary, and if you don't like her, you won't. It's that simple. She's just one of those people that people feel very strongly either way about. I enjoyed it. I thought it was great. I wish there was a few more honest, real, raw moments, but overall, I had a good time watching it, and the most shocking part of this entire thing was the fact that she had not eaten a burrito until 2 years ago. Like, what? How have you never had a burrito? And she also puts ice in her wine, which I found very interesting. It's called Taylor Swift, Miss Americana, and it is now streaming on Netflix. Until next time.
He'll watch a movie, then he'll tell you all about it. It's the Armstrong Entertainment Show.